So here's one last helpful loop, the for in loop. For in loops let us easily iterate through arrays or objects. The syntax looks like this. The same keyword for, we have some kind of iterator, which we can give any name that we want. Then we have the keyword in, and then an object or array that we want to iterate through. For each of the items in some object, we want to do something. Just like before, we put the conditions for a for loop inside parentheses and the statements we want to execute inside curly braces. It's important to note here that this item, this iterator in this list, is actually the index of the item in the object, not the value held at the index in the object. So let's take a look at an example. We have an array called countries, which has the top four teams of the 2014 World Cup. We have a for in loop here, which is going to iterate for each country in the country's array. We want to log that country. Hey James, do you see anything wrong with this code?
It's just going to print out 0 through 3 and not the actual country name.
Why is that?
Because country is an iterator in countries. It's not the actual value of country.
That's right. So let's make a change. Instead, we should have console.log countries of the index country. Let's see if this is correct. So here's our for in loop in one line of code. By using shift enter, we can actually put this in a much nicer format. So we see for country in countries, console.log countries country. And in pressing enter, we see Germany, Argentina, Brazil, and the Netherlands.
You should already have a work object with all of your work experiences. I want you to write a for in loop that iterates over all the jobs in your work object and appends them in a new HTML work start element. I want you to also format each job's employer with HTML work employer and each job title with HTML work title and append all of that to the page. Click this box when you're done.